This is Kevin Mayo, your American correspondent for Real Ale Craft Beer. And today we're drinking River Horse Hop Hazard. It's an American, an unfiltered American pale ale. River Horse is a smaller brewery out of Ewing, New Jersey. We don't normally get it up here. I got one of my sons who's living in New Jersey. He brought it up for me last weekend to give it a try. So I'm pretty excited to be reviewing it for the Real Ale Craft Beer channel because it's something that you don't get a lot of play, you don't see a lot of. So it's a little bit rare for us people up here. 6.5% alcohol by volume. On the website, I looked it up. There's two or three different hops in it. I think Chinook and Cascade are two of them. But there's not a lot of other information on there. Something about the owners took it over in 2007 and they'd rather brew beer than work at a desk job, which just makes sense. So they're from New Jersey, so we're going to use our Cape May Brewing glass from last summer. Let's give it a crack and give it a pour. So it is unfiltered, so we should have some haze in it, but we'll see. And usually pales aren't supposed to be all that hoppy, so that'll be interesting too. Not an overly aggressive pour. I got two fingers of head. It is a dark orange. It definitely is unfiltered. It's very hazy, and there's some nice chunks of stuff floating around in it, which doesn't bother me in the least. That adds to the flavor. And then the head's actually more of a beige. Let's do the aroma. So I get a little bit of that bready malty up front. A little bit of dankness, a little bit of green grass. And maybe a little bit of mango. There's no date on the bottle, so I don't know how fresh this is. Let's give it a taste. It pretty much follows the aroma. Up front, it's got a nice bready malty flavor, and actually it finishes with a nice hint of toffee caramel. And it's kind of sweet up front, and then the hops really kick in, so it's got some nice bitter in it at the back end. I mean, you can taste it at the back of your throat, but it doesn't linger and really burn on the back of the throat either. So we got caramel, just the slightest hint of the grass from the aroma. Just a, well, not just a hint, but we mentioned earlier, we got a little bit of caramel toffee in there, a little bit of grass, maybe a little bit of the citrus. Let's get the rest in there. Get all the chunks floating around in there. I didn't say it earlier, but there is a fair amount of carbonation on this beer, too. It's a fairly typical pale ale with just a bit of a kicked up bitter aftertaste. I'm trying to think of something that's similar to it. Sierra Nevada pale ale, which we all drink, has probably got a little more citrusy, grapefruity flavors. This is almost like an English bitter, but then with a true bitter aftertaste on it. Good little beer. I would drink it again. I wouldn't rush out and buy it probably, but I would definitely drink it again. Matter of fact, I think I have more in the fridge. I got one other beer that I'm reviewing on my channel, so that'll be coming up shortly. So we'll see how that one comes out. So I would give this, I give it an 80 out of 100. It's drinkable, reasonably sessionable at 6.5%. Flavor-wise, it's reasonably tame with some bitter at the back end. Till next time, keep drinking.